Next question here, we need to find out the dimension of epsilon naught permittivity in vacuum. So this is permittivity. In vacuum, and we have to find out mu zero permeability. Again in vacuum. Okay, to find out permittivity, so permittivity is coming into Coulomb's law. So from Coulomb's law. From Coulomb's law, we know F equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square. Okay, so from this equation, so here we are getting this permittivity epsilon naught. So epsilon naught equal to, it is coming 1 by 4 pi. So we'll just put that equation and then we will see how F into R square, so how these dimensions are coming. So now this is constant, we all know that. So here it is coming 1 by F. F is the force, so 1 by, let's put this way, mass L t to the power minus 2 mass into acceleration, okay, into say 1 by R square means L square into it is a Q. So Q means it is the charge, and we can say, let's say, denote as Q. So it is coming to Q square. Okay, so now charge is not the fundamental unit. So basic unit, in the basic unit, charge is not there. So we can put Q equal to I into T is the time, I is the ampere. So T is the time and I is the ampere. Then the charge per time is ampere. So we'll just replace the value of dimension of Q by I and T. So here it is coming M to the power minus 1. It is coming L to the power minus 3. Then T square. Then Q square means it will be I square T square, because it is ampere into time. So if we simplify, M to the power minus 1, L to the power minus 3, T to the power 4, then I means it is basically ampere, A to the power 2, so A square. So this is the dimension of mu 0. Permittivity. Now, to find out the dimension of mu zero, we'll take that help of Ampere's law. So we'll take that help of Ampere's circuit law. So you will see in class 12 that Ampere's circuit law, it is the closed integral of magnetic field B and length dl is coming to mu 0 into the current I. And from here, if we just consider the dimension part, then it is coming B into L by I is the current, so B is the magnetic field. So again, in case of the magnetic field in the B, we have to take that help of the magnetic force. F equals to Q. If Q charge is there and it goes in a V velocity in a B magnetic field, the force will be F equal to Q V B. So, and from here we will find B equal to F is the force by Q into V. it's very easy. You can just derive, and you have to just put that equation of that magnetic force, that's all. And the force dimension, same, we all know that mLt^-2 q, nothing but I into t. So I is ampere, then t, here t is time, so you can put directly, then v l t^-1. So if we derive, see, here we are deriving the dimension of b, so here it is coming ll cancelling out, t minus t cancelling out, so let's put a, then a t^-2, this t going out, this l going out, ll going out, t going out, a^-1. So this is the value of b. So mu zero dimension will be m t^-2 a^-1 into l, then in bottom it is ampere, means it will be a, so it is coming m t^-2 l a^-2. So this is the dimension of m l t^-2 a^-2. So this is the dimension of mu zero.